comfortable. The grill's real nice.
Yeah, the grill.
Even my dad's car doesn't have stitching like that.
You know, the trunk is really neat.
The interior is really roomy.
I love the stitch work.
Actually, there's enough room for me to get it, and I'm about 6'3".
Pretty nice.
Dad picked me up this car. I'm impressed.
$35,000 to $40,000 at least.
$35,000?
$32,000.
Are you sure?
Wow. It's impossible. It's impossible.
I might have to go get one.
I want to.
Oh, I'd be impressed.
I would be shocked. Where can we buy one?
Really?
Okay, now will you tell me what it is?
Ford?
Really?
Ford.
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 No, it is a Ford.
Well, good afternoon. How's everybody doing? Thanks for coming out, and I'm sure that you're getting your own up close and personal experience with this new Fusion. And I think you can see why we're so enthused. I will tell you that the video you just saw was made a couple of miles from here, and we didn't pay the people, we didn't do anything. I don't necessarily hold them out as being the most knowledgeable car people in the world, but I do think that their reaction is somewhat representative of what a lot of other people will have. You know, it sort of gets you into the question of what's this car, this Fusion, mean to the Ford brand? Why is it so important to Ford? And my answer is very straightforward. This vehicle helps us get back to the original roots of Ford Motor Company of providing value transportation to large numbers of people, and it's a product that takes on all comers, foreign or domestic. It is true that at launch we expect 75% of the sales to go to our own customers. We view this as a good thing because, frankly, we know that there are over 50,000 people a year who currently own our products and don't renew or buy another one because their perception was we didn't have a product like this. This is not to say that we don't believe, because I do, that we can also make very serious inroads with many of the import people as well, because as you drive this vehicle, you will come to understand this is a very serious competitor across the board. We take no prisoners, we make no apology. Let's face it, for quite some time, we've concentrated on certain sections of the business and neglected others. Ford is back in the car business. Make no mistake about it. This, in combination with the 500, does a lot for us, and we have other products coming behind this. Jarlin Jones is going to talk to you about some of the specific marketing aspects, but the message that I want to convey as clearly as possible is that this product is broad-based. We believe it'll be attractive to younger people, but it's the utility and the attributes and functions that it possesses will enable this product to appeal to a wide range, a wide economic range. The value proposition here with the base product starting at $17,995, a well-equipped product for around $20,000, is extremely competitive. Fuel economy is also something that obviously with what's going on today, raising beyond our previous expectations, but fuel economy is an important consideration and has been for a lot of people. And having a four-cylinder, a viable four-cylinder competitor, as long as a six-cylinder that delivers in the mid-20s, is a very good step forward for us. residual value is also something that's come in quite well on this product and will enable us to put a marketing proposition to the consumers that's much better than anything we've had recently. So all these things together are why I am bullish on this product and I am bullish on the prospects of Ford Division. Talking about Ford Division, obviously the industry reported sales today. And I just got an email back from the office, and our estimate is that industry sales were up 4%. Ford Motor Company was up 6%. Ford Division was up 8%. The 8% was primarily in cars. We held our own in trucks, and we had one outstanding truck month going until the last week, where I think fuel economy did start to impact, particularly the SUVs. Because I'm also here to tell you that after an all-time any-month record on F-Series in July, we established an all-time August F-Series sales record in August, doing over 90,000 of them. So last month, it was July, it was 127 something or another. This month, it's 90 some odd. We're slightly ahead of where we were with F-Series sales last year. Your guess is as good as mine as to what the next few months bring. We outsold Chevrolet by 42,000 pieces, and it's going to be a pretty interesting race between now and the end of the year as it relates to who has dominance. By the way, our fleet business for the most part has been stable to declining, and a number of our competitors, particularly DCX and GM, have had pretty significant increases in fleet. But a unit's a unit. They all count, so we'll see what happens. I'm going to bring Jarlin out in a second, but getting back to this car, whether it's the one you see over here, which will be on the circuit at NASCAR, and we expect to do real well with it. We've already had a lot of comments about it. Or if it's this one over here, which shall we say is the street legal version, we are bullish on Fusion. So, Jarlin,